Good morning. On this beautiful Resurrection Sunday morning, when the spring is in the air and all the buds are starting to emerge, we see the little flowers starting to rear their little heads out. I'd like to encourage everyone to make a plan for some sort of regular and purposeful physical activity, otherwise known as exercise. Now, there are many, many benefits. Keep the smiles on your faces. Keep the resurrection smiles on your faces. There are many, many benefits for regular exercise. For example, it can help you maintain your weight, feel happier, sleep better, improve your memory, reduce stress, control your blood pressure, and lower your LDL, which is that bad cholesterol that builds up in your blood, and raise your HDL, which is that good cholesterol. Now, I know all of us could use one of those things, at least one of those things, on that list. So in addition, the widespread health benefit of physical activity can help us lower the risk of developing other conditions, such as heart disease and stroke, because a sedentary lifestyle works against health and wellness. So we know all the reasons why we should, but let's tackle some of the reasons why we don't. Do any of these sound familiar to you? It's too hard, the results take too long, it's not fun, it's too expensive, or I just don't have time. Well, I'm with you on a lot of those, but let's just break down some of those barriers, because there is a yes for every no. If it seems too hard, or that you think that you have to spend hours at the gym, well, that's really just not true. You can walk 10 minutes after dinner. That might just be a way for you to get started and gradually work yourself up to about 30 minutes on most days, not every day. And if you miss a day, you miss a day. But just, it's the press that makes the difference. If it seems like your results take too long, the good news is that some of the benefits are immediate, but you just don't see them. But they are occurring. For example, as your heart rate and your breathing increases, more blood and oxygen are flowing through your body, and your muscles are benefiting from the movement. All of this is leading to a healthier body. And you can't, of course, get fit in a week, but making physical activity a part of your life will get results. If it seems like you're not having fun, well, try something new. If you get bored easily, you can, exercise with a friend, do some aerobics, or there's a lot of things that are free at the local Y or a local gym that you can participate in. Again, if it's too expensive, don't go for an expensive gym membership, particularly if you know that you're not going to go, because that's just really a waste of money. And I know a few of us, I know I've done that before, and I know that I'm not the only one. But just find ways in the day to squeeze exercise in, like taking the stairs instead of the elevator, spend time playing with your children or your grandchildren outside, and get up and move around during commercials if you're watching your favorite program. Getting 20 minutes in every day is better than an hour once or twice a week, and it's easier to fit into your schedule. It's not so overwhelming. And just remember that a lot of it is in the preparation. And it might seem that active people have tons of willpower and discipline, and they're just, they're always on track. But what they really probably have is a plan. And I know somebody who says, write the vision on paper. Make it plain. Write it down and put it somewhere where you can see it. Remember, doing something is much better than doing nothing. Getting started is the key, and it's everything. Start small, don't overwhelm yourself. Everybody's different, don't worry about what other people are doing. Just do what works for you. And consistency is the key. Somebody say, yes, we can. Yes, we can. We're gonna resurrect our exercise plans and programs as we start through this new season of Springtown. Amen?
Amen.